What's up everybody, this is Dark Wolf Age bringing you the awesome stuff today and beyond. While back, I went to my local flea market, which I honestly love to visit from time to time, just to see if there was some pretty cool random stuff. Well, one of those random items that I happened to pick up, and I was fortunate enough to be able to find one, was the CRT monitor. It is not just any CRT monitor, but it is a Commodore 1084D CRT video monitor. Manufactured by 𝐒𝐨𝐜𝐢 in August 1989, this monitor has the capability to run at 50Hz. Although I wish it could have ran both 50 and 60Hz, but this is still not bad at all. The inputs that this beautiful Commodore video monitor provides are a 9-DIN pin RGB input, a toggle switch between analog and digital RGB mode, chroma input, a regular video input, and a single audio mono input followed by your power supply. Now this monitor wasn't like this when I first picked it up. It was rather disgustingly dirty from the outside and the inside. Honestly, I thought this monitor was dead and there was no way for me in reviving it at all, but I decided to be optimistic about it. After taking the time in disassembling, cleaning the PCB board, and checking the PCB board for any leakage in bad capacitors or broken resistors, I was fortunate that I was able to get this video monitor up and running and giving it a second life. The best part, ever since I made my own modded RGB cable using one of my many broken Sega Genesis D-pad controllers, the result that this video monitor gives off is remarkably stunning. And if you're interested in learning how to make this 9-DIN connector RGB cable for your own Commodore CRT monitor, stay tuned for future video tutorials for that one. That being said, don't let the camera video footage shot fool you into thinking that this monitor is broken due to the random flickering that you're seeing right now. That is because this effect is common when filming directly at any CRT monitor. I absolutely love this monitor and it is one hell of a goldmine pickup, as it is one of the many greatest CRT monitors that are outside in the wild, and this is perfect for retro gaming. But like with any random pickups that you get from a flea market, thrift store, Craigslist, or even eBay, one of the biggest issues that I have to face with this Commodore video monitor is that I cannot, for some strange reason, turn it off by pressing the power switch. It is as if this power switch is just stuck. I immediately knew what the problem was, so I got myself one of these guys. These are common CRT power switches which I happened to pick up from my local electronics store. They are the same switches that are used on a regular consumer CRT TV. Using my multimeter and switching the settings to continuity, I hooked up my multimeter probes to each side of the switch pins to check and examine the switch's pinout that toggles between the on and off switch. Plus, it also helps for me to check and see if the switch actually works. And it does. With this info in mind, it is time to go and disassemble the Commodore CRT video monitor. Warning! Before we go any further, I would like to remind you that if you plan on working and doing repairs on any CRT monitors, regardless of how old they are, you have to be extremely careful. That is because if you do not know your ways around on how to handle a CRT monitor correctly, you could potentially cause yourself to get into some serious injury due to that CRT monitors carry heavy voltage. So always keep that in mind. Otherwise, consult a local electrician, a friend, or someone that is well experienced with working on CRT monitors to lend you a helping hand. With all that said, sit back, buckle up, take some note downs, and let's get started. First off, make sure that before you place your monitor on a hard surface, such as this ceramic floor, is to make sure to have it on top of some sort of padding cushion. I'm using a regular workout mattress here, and the reason why I do this is because when it's time for me to lay down the heavy glass monitor facing down on the floor, the glass would not get scratched. From here, we need to remove the back case screws, and in my case, there are a total of 6 screws. Yours could be different. There are 4 main screws that hold the back and 2 screws that are close to the video input. I'll go ahead and fast forward this process. Once we've removed the screws, be sure to lift the back panel gently. Reason being is because of the mono speaker wires that are attached to the front panel of the CRT monitor, as we don't want to yank those carelessly. So just lift it up, set it down gently, and unplug the mono speaker wires that are connected to the front panel PCB board. Before we go any further, we need to go ahead and discharge this CRT monitor. For this, you'll need a flathead screwdriver and a pair of alligator clips with a solid wire that are connected to each end of the clips. Take one end of the alligator clip and clip the first one to the flathead screwdriver, like so. As for the other end of the alligator clip, we need to make sure that we clip that to any grounded surface on our CRT monitor. This can be the middle back area of the video input, or you can use the metal frame of the CRT monitor. Once we have attached the second clip to our grounded source, be sure to wear rubber gloves before performing the discharge. Now that we have everything in place and we have double checked our safety checklist, it is time to discharge. Gently slide the flathead screwdriver under the rubber suction cup and be sure that the flathead screwdriver is touching the metal prong's connection. When the screwdriver touches the metal prong, you should be able to hear a static sound, and it could be loud, faint, or none at all. But regardless, you have to do this step. Once we know that we have successfully discharged the monitor, slowly push one end of the metal prongs to remove the whole suction cup cable out. And just to be extra safe, touch both metal prongs of the suction cup cable with your flathead screwdriver, like so. And to be extra safe, insert the flathead screwdriver slightly inside the CRT monitor where the location of the metal prongs were, just to be sure that it is completely discharged. And that's it, you have successfully discharged your CRT monitor. We can now move on to the next step. Now, we need to locate our power switch, and in my case, it is on the front panel of this monitor. Let us examine this area to see what it is exactly we are dealing with. We can see that the power switch wires are connected to a one-sided area of the power supply PCB board. At this point, I like to do a few things, and that is to take note of the power switch wiring location and wire placement of the power supply PCB board. Once we have our notes and backup reference image taken, it is time we move our attention to the power switch. Start by unscrewing the screws of the power switch metal shield holder that is attached to the front panel case. From here, we need to remove two more screws that hold the power switch together. Now that we have the power switch completely exposed, lift the heat shrink tubing. If your heat shrink tubing does not come off, you can always cut them off with a blade. Once you have removed the heat shrink tubing and exposed the wire, it is time to desolder the wires that are attached to the power switch. After desoldering, we now have successfully removed our old damaged power switch. So it is time to replace it with a new one. But before we do that, we need to remove one essential piece from the old damaged power switch. Here we have our old damaged power switch, and here's our new one. You see that the old power switch, there's a black plastic holder piece. We need to go ahead and remove that and apply it to the new power switch. To do so, simply pry it off by adding a bit of force, lifting it, and sliding it up. It should come right off. From here, we're going to go to our new power switch, and we need to go ahead and remove this metal thingy right there and just pry it off using a pair of pliers. Once we have that removed, we simply go ahead and replace that with the black plastic piece that we removed earlier from the old power switch and apply it to this one. And it should look like this. From here, I'm going to go ahead and snip off two of these pins because there's no need for them at all. That's it. Our new power switch is ready to be applied and soldered to our CRT monitor. In the soldering process, I want to make sure that each of the four pins of the power switch have been pre-tinned, which I did, but I forgot to shoot the video footage during the filming process of this tutorial. But rest assured that I have pre-tinned all four pins on this power switch, as pre-tinning is a common practice in any soldering process to ensure that you have a solid connection. So here, you can see that I am adding new flux to the pre-tinned pins on the power switch. After adding the flux and having things ready to be soldered, what I like to do is to add new heat shrink tubing to each of the four wires to set them up and have them to be ready and used after the soldering process. From there, we go ahead and start soldering each wire to the correct pins on this switch. This is where our previous notes that we have jotted down and taken that backup photo reference earlier before the whole disassembly process comes in really handy. That is because it's going to make things a lot easier and simple in knowing the location of each individual wire strands are supposed to be located correctly on the power switch pinout. Pop on back the heat shrink tubes and use any heat source such as this lighter here to shrink down the tubes on all four pins on the power switch. That's it! We have successfully soldered each of our four wires to the correct pins on our new power switch. It is time to put this power switch back in its original placement and reassemble the whole CRT monitor back together. And to make things faster, I'm going to go ahead and fast forward the whole reassembling process. Let's do this. And we are done. And now for the moment of truth. Let's go ahead and fire up our gaming console and let us see if this new power switch actually works. Success! It works! And it works flawless. We have successfully fixed our CRT monitor. The switch works perfectly. And I can go ahead and turn it off, turn it on to my heart content, and it would not get stuck. It works perfect. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video tutorial and learned something new from it that you never have picked up before. If you have enjoyed this video, kindly give it a thumbs up. Do definitely leave me a feedback, as I always like to read your comments. And most importantly, consider subscribing to my channel, as it really does help me out in putting out high quality content videos for you. That being said, I also happen to do Twitch streaming from time to time, and if you are interested in keeping up to date with me live, consider following me on my Twitter and Instagram accounts. All the links will be below in the description box. Once again, thank you so much for watching this video. This is Dark Wolf 80s, signing off. Have a good one.